like Southern classrooms in the 50s, peaceful Northern lakes seem unlikely battlegrounds for the 1980s.
In the name of decency, which we all serve, what is happening in America?
I am responsible for ensuring public safety. Today in northern Wisconsin, public safety is at risk.
Need a white man over there to count?
They are always seeking the help of the police to protect them, but they are the first to criticize the police when the police are unable to protect them. You just can't guarantee the safety of a fool, and that's what these folks are, just fools.
To me, it may mean I don't like Indians. Maybe it'll mean I do like Indians. Maybe it means I don't like them stirring fish.
When you see signs like timber niggers and things like that, that tells you who's up there protesting. You know, this is kind of like the Mississippi of the North.
It's not an economic issue. It's a racist issue.
It's not racist. It's a fishing issue.
Americans are free and sure to disagree with the law, but not to disobey it. No man, however prominent or powerful, and no mob, however unruly or boisterous, is entitled to defy a court of law.
I mean, if it was the number of walleyes on the lake, that's not a reason to threaten to kill somebody for taking a few fish off the lake.
The spear fisherman's wife asks the mob, is this a fishing issue?
Or is this a racist problem?
This is not a racial problem.
You guys can catch him with hook and line just like us.
Hey, are you a citizen?
And their children are watching this. That this is what they are absorbing. And they'll turn around someday and they'll probably do the same thing.
I have a hard time reconciling what's going on here with what I know of my state.
We're not fighting for ourselves. We're fighting for the state of Wisconsin.
Makes me sick.
Red like the nurse!
Makes me sick.
So you would have thought that we would have learned. But apparently we haven't learned. I remember whites only signs at water fountains and whites only signs in bus depots, and you saw cops with riot gear, and you had white crowds jeering the black kids as they were trying to get into school, and you had rocks being thrown, and you had violence, and you had people calling out racial epithets. All you have to do is replace the Indians with black people, and you have almost an exactly same type of situation, except that you have the surface issue here being spearfishing.
Remember that people who sought to integrate lunch counters, schools, transportation systems were arrested. Unlike the South, here law enforcement is on the side of those who seek to exercise their constitutional right.
Well, I think they hauled away the Grand Wizard tonight, so that tells you something.
Be careful what you say.
Many Northerners resent Ku Klux Klan and civil rights comparisons. Dean Crist heads up the Stop Treaty Abuse Organization and is the man Chippewas tab, the Grand Wizard.
They desperately try and make it a racial issue. It wouldn't make any difference if it was the Aryan Nation out there taking 100% of the resource or the Chippewa Nation.
They'll judge us. They'll judge the Indian by what their race has done, their race that has, you know, not only destroyed the buffalo, but you could do the wolf. You could just keep going on and on and on. I have a feeling that they're thinking if that was me out there, they'd somehow find a way of getting them all. But the Indian's not like that at all.
Like Southern blacks, Nick Hocking says Chippewa Indians wish to live in harmony with whites under laws hammered out long before walleyes were worth fighting for.
You've had some rather personal and trying experiences yourself. Are you afraid?
No, I'm not. Ultimately, along the way of life, an individual must stand up and be counted and be willing to face the consequences, whatever they are. And if he is filled with fear, he cannot do it.
With tonight's special emphasis, I'm Joel Despain.
I didn't see
They say there was no tension between Indians and whites here in northern Wisconsin until 5 years ago. That's when the Supreme Court upheld a Chippewa treaty guaranteeing hunting and fishing rights in the northern third of Wisconsin, both off and on the reservation, rights the Chippewa hadn't exercised in over 100 years. One of these rights was spear fishing during the spawning season of some of Wisconsin's prime game fish, walleyes and muskies. In an area where tourism is the only industry, resort owners and local fishermen are furious.
How do you feel about the Indians?
You know, I'm my opinion on them.
Under your boots, you sly bag.
Here's my leg.
Hey, how do I get boots down? Hey, bird. You're fat enough, you sly bag.
Are you?
How come you didn't arrest him for assault and theft when he pulled in when he's trying to? Oh, I hope you drowned, you Chickasaw.
They say the issue is spearfishing.
Do you think people up here are really angry?
Really angry?
Yeah.
You'll see it by the protest.
Yeah.
You'll see a couple arrests tonight at least.
Really?
Think that there's less people here, but we don't realize that those two spotlights, there's probably 100 behind each one of those.
Oh, yeah?
And at Randy's bar on their landing down below, there's probably another couple hundred. I would say that by the time you got done going around the lake, probably about 1,000.
Oh, really?
This is a big lake, 400 and some acres.
As local residents patrolled Bearskin Lake in their boats, a single Chippewa spearfishing party went out, heavily protected by National Guard on land and DNR boats on the lake. As their boat entered the water, protesters began to throw rocks.
20 feet, you missed! Rock them!
Rock!
Don't give your palms, you pudlet! Put your money on a ball instead of pap!
Good shot!
You got him between the legs, but there's nothing there!
Molson
bit it off!
Hello!
Hi!
I didn't throw that rock.
Did you throw a rock?
No, I didn't
he
throw
it. He picked it up, a big boulder. Cops right there, he's like...
See them flashlights? The flashlights are right on us, real bright, shining in my eyes right now.
How you doing, motherfuckers?
It wasn't me!
Chippewa spearfishing leader Tom Molson is said to have a $30,000 price tag on his head. That's a lot of money in northern Wisconsin.
So are you going to a lot of these protests? Do you go regularly?
I've been to two so far.
What do you hope to accomplish by going?
I hope to get these Indians off the lakes.
They say the issue is spearfishing.
Well, fine. If that's what they want to go to go back to the birch canoes that they built themselves in their own homemade spears, then it'd be different. But they're not doing that. They used to use a torch, not spotlight. They didn't have protection then. They went out. From what I understand, their belief was that this is their mother. So they're raping their mother. And they're not using their old-fashioned religious beliefs. They're using modern-day conveniences that we made, that we thought up. You know, we created, not them.
Yeah. They say racism has nothing to do with it.
How many timber niggers are there? Thousands of timber niggers!
I think the only appropriate response to that is...
Over the past 10 days, I've been to a number of spearfishing boat landings. They're filled with tension, shrouded in darkness, emotions running high, disorderly conduct, obscene language, arrests. We've seen it all. And in a curious way, they've also become a place of hope. Because deep down, I think the people at these boat landings, people of reason, will see that human beings of different races and heritages must one day see eye to eye.
It's not racial.
What is it?
What the hell?
It's a two-job everybody around here. Everyone's white.
Basically, we've got to live in this world cooperatively.
We think that the law is outdated. We're here just to demonstrate that we're not happy with the law.
What it's doing is it's projecting an image nationwide and internationally that it in fact is committing economic suicide.
This action out here by these tribal people on these waters has already definitely hurt Wisconsin. This is not an issue of fishing anymore. This is an issue of straight money, M-O-N-E-Y money.
They have no knowledge, no understanding whatsoever about treaty issues. Treaties are sacred documents on par with the Constitution of the United States. But they don't know anything about that. They've never been taught anything about that. That's all they have is a John Wayne frontier mentality of what Indian people are all about. John Wayne is dead. John Wayne is dead. And they should let him go right here today.
Come beating on your door. I know that I'm a prisoner to all my father held so dear. I know that I'm a hostage to all his hopes and fears. I just wish I could have told him.